Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends. In the previous lecture also, while discussing about the group 14 elements, we have discussed about that how the carbon is basically different from that of the other elements, even though it is belonging to the same group. So now let us discuss about what are the different properties that are being exhibited by the carbon that makes the carbon to be different compared to that of the other elements in terms of the property. So now let us discuss about that. So here in this topic, we are going to talk about the anomalous properties or anomalous behavior of the carbon in the group 14 elements. As you know that the different properties of the carbon, that is the main thing is because of its atomic size. So carbon is the most smallest atom and which has the smallest atomic size in the whole group 14 element, and that is the reason that it has higher electronegativity also. And because of its higher electronegativity and smaller atomic size, the ionization enthalpy of carbon is also more, and we have discussed that is it was thought to be more than 1000 kilojoules of energy has been required just to remove the outermost electron. So that is comparatively, if we compare it with the other elements like that of silicon or the other one like suppose germanium, it is drastic change that we could observe, and that's the reason that carbon is basically in terms of property it is different from that of the other one. And now let me discuss about the other property which we have not discussed earlier, that is carbon has a special kind of property that is known as caffeination. And what is caffeination? Related to this we are going to talk about in a next topic also, but let me give you a brief idea. That is, caffeination is the formation of a bond with the similar elements. So that's the reason that the carbon is now widely spread in the whole world, and in form of cellulose, starch, food, plastic, and everywhere like polythene. So everywhere carbon has been present, and that's the reason that it has a tendency of caffeination. And talking about the next one, that is the bond enthalpy. Since the bond enthalpy of the carbon is more, that's the reason that it forms various bonds with the other carbon atoms, and to break that it is very much difficult. So this was related to the caffeination, and the next one is basically multiple bond. If you talk about the group 14 elements, the group 14 elements doesn't forms a double bond except carbon. So we have also discussed about the chapters like alkenes, alkynes, and alkanes, in basically which carbon forms bond with the other carbon. So as we have discussed in the chapter, that is alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes, so basically carbon has a property of formation of double bond. So that's the reason that they can form carbon-carbon double bond, they can form carbon-carbon triple bond also, but not only related with the similar elements. So it can also form the double bond with oxygen, like in carbon monoxide or in carbon dioxide. We could see that carbon forms a double bond with oxygen. So this is a different property that are being exhibited by the carbon that is not being exhibited by the other elements belonging to the group 14. So this is a different property of the carbon that I was talking about, and that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know that why carbon is basically having a different property in the group 14 element. So thank you. I hope you will share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.